This is Harvey Cook with SuperForm Products. We're here going to video part two of a two-part video series, installing ICFVL floor hangers for a ledger board. When you're building ICF right to the roof and you want to hang those floor trusses inside the foundation wall. First step, we've determined what our ceiling height is going to be in the house. Our floor trusses are 18 inches deep with a 3-inch top cord bearing. We need to be 15 inches up from the top of the bearing wall to the underside of the top cord bearing. So we're going to transfer a mark over here to our ICF wall with our laser. We're going to put a mark on the wall. We're going to come down because this is a long wall. I'm not going to snap 40 feet of wall with one string line. I'm going to put another laser mark here. At this point on our wall, we're going to come and snap a chalk line on this ICF wall through my two laser marks that we have put on there. That black line is the top of my ledger board. So now we're going to install this LVL with some 3-inch deck screws into a web. One at the very top of that LVL. Phil, how does that look?
Nice.
The reason I'm doing this is then I don't have to fight trying to hold that heavy ledger board as I'm putting those hangers on. These screws are gonna hold that in place for me. Now that that ledger board is fastened up there, now it's time to install an ICFVL-CW. You can see where the embedded part is in the ICF. That tells me that's where I need to put this CW part. What I do is take an 1.5-inch deck screw, fasten that on. This portion of the hanger needs to be tight to the bottom of the ledger board. No space whatsoever. If there is space, your floor system is going to shift on you as time passes. They're a self-tapping structural screw. They come one screw for every hole in this hanger. No more, no less. Do not lose them. I can't stress that enough. Now we're going to put these screws in. And this takes a little torque. Did you see how it pulled that board in? That's what I mean by burning out the tip of the screw. Do not throw that screw away. You need that screw. What I'm gonna do is grab a brand new one, go back into that same hole. I just was pointing out that I got another hole put through that hanger with a good screw. Now I'm gonna use the one with the burned out tip on it. And I'm gonna put it in that hole. Done like dinner. Now I'm gonna pull out that 1.5-inch deck screw here. And I'm gonna put the screws for the ICF hangers in there. So there, I've got a screw in each hole on my ICFVL-CW hangers, fastened through my embedded part of the hanger into my ICF wall. There's that ledger board part. This is a 2x4. This is a 3-inch top cord bearing floor truss, 1.5-inch thick, 1.75 inches on the LVL, makes 3.25. We've got 3.5 inches of tail. We glue that on, put it up against our LVL, flush it up to the top of the LVL, spike it on. So this is a bottom cord bearing end of that same floor truss. Notice it's got no overhang here. the bottom of this floor truss is going to sit on top of my bearing wall in the foundation. It's designed that way. So the one end, it's got the top cord bearing, and the opposite end has got a bottom cord bearing. Because these are open web floor trusses, I know that the cord is 3.5 inches wide. We've done our layout. First one starts at the ICF and back. Second one starts 17.5 inches and away. And from that point, we're gonna be 19.3 inches on center. I'll show you guys that. Ledger board's on, we put a floor truss on, and I just want you guys to see that floor is absolutely perfect. Can't stress it enough. The footings are the most important part of building a house. You get them in, your project is gonna be way easier. It's gonna come out nicer, it'll be perfect. So thank you very much from SuperForm Products, taking the time out of your day to watch this two-part video series on installing ICFVLs embedded in the ICFs. Enjoy your day.